All right, so we are in the middle of our journey, and now I feel it's the perfect time for filming an introduction. So, hello and welcome to our video. So, this is our sort of like a vlog wherein we are going to explain everything about our journey to McLeodganj, starting with the planning phase, which started with booking the bus tickets, which he did. So, I'll let him speak for this.
It was pretty easy. You can quickly search on the Redbus or any of the websites that you find feasible. I would say Redbus is the best one because you can find all the buses there. Try to look not for the weekends, look for somewhere on Thursdays or Fridays. So you will get a lot cheaper prices.
Yeah, almost like half the price.
Exactly, because we booked a ticket for 12th night, which costed us around 1,334 per person, as compared to if I would have booked it on 13th or 14th, it would have costed me around 2,100 per person. So we just saved like 800 bucks from that particular aspect. And if you're a new Redbus user, you can always, you know, use
get a coupon.
Yeah.
Right. Or get your parents' mobile numbers. And yeah. Sign up as a new user.
Or you can use our referral code and you can use that as well if you feel like. So that's that. You can also get the discount on that. Post booking the buses.
That's when I did the booking for the hotel. So I was looking for a budget-friendly hotel, a decent one, like not too bad and not too high-priced. So that's when I started calling a bunch of places, started looking at all the different photos. And plus, when I found the one that I was looking for, I compared it with various different websites. So sometimes that it happens that they give you a better deal when you book them privately, but for this occasion I found a better deal by comparing various websites like GoIBibo, Make My Trip and all those websites. Yeah. I compared the prices and I found that I got a better deal over there. So instead of booking them directly, I decided to book them through the website. So
we booked it via GoIBibo, by the way.
Yeah. And that costed us somewhere around 800, 850 per night.
No, 700 for two nights, 3 days.
Yep. Yeah. So that was a great deal. Yeah. Okay. Coming on to the actual journey. So you might see a lot of buses, which would say that they are luxury Mercedes-Benz, Volvo buses. But
until they don't say that, like the one that we took, it did not say that it belongs to Bharat Benz or Mercedes Benz. Uh-huh. But if you will, you know, there are some kind of travelers like Bedi Travels, AN Holidays, Lakshmi mm-hmm. Holidays, and stuff like that. We booked this from Bedi Holidays, but Bedi one was it's okay.
Yeah. And plus, we had a child on board. Just like the seat next to us.
I have no grudges against any of the kids. But every time we tried to sleep and she started to cry in a very
outrageous
weird
manner.
And that's very weird.
And the kid's parents weren't able to control the kid. So
I mean, it's fine. If he's just a kid, that's not a problem. But,
You
know, so we couldn't not sleep well.
Sleep even for a second.
Right. So despite of the fact that we are sleep deprived, what we did is we kept our stuffs to our hotel.
Mm-hmm. And most of the hotels are kind enough. All you gotta do is you just need to call them prior to your booking and you need to ask them for if you can place your stuff or your luggage on the day of your trekking, and most likely they would say yes, because I spoke with 4 or 5 hotels and all of them said yes.
I mean, why she is saying this, because she did not share the context with you. Why she is saying this, because we did not book anything for today.
Yeah.
We have a booking for tomorrow, and that is why we are saying that hotels will allow you to keep your luggage even if you did not book for the next day. Just call them and confirm.
Yeah.
You don't know, some individual might be finicky about that fact, so we, you know, we cannot guarantee on that. But most of them, whosoever we called, were like very nice and said, yeah sir, we can keep your luggage. So this is what we did. We kept our luggage and we, you know,
so we are checking in tomorrow because we are staying over here overnight. So we are almost like at 4 kilometers up, and we still have two left.
Two left
to go.
If you're first time hikers like us, I would prefer this route. Be well prepared. We were.
All right. So let's tell them about the route. And now let me just cut it. So we've reached the bus stop, which is Majnuga Tila, and our unfortunate luck that we believed the bus driver and came like an hour early, and now the bus is not here yet and we are waiting for the bus.
Actually it is here, it is standing on the other side. They called us and said that you can be here by 8, its boarding time is 9, but we will be leaving early because people can be alive early. And I think that was a bullshit, never believe that. Reach on the time.
Yeah.
That's a shitty experience, I would say. But let's see, I don't have much hope from the bus as well. Okay, so this is our first pit stop, which is at, I first thought they will stop at Sukhdev, Amrit Sukhdev. It's very popular in Motu, but apparently they did not. But it's a better place, I would say. They stopped at Haveli, which is at the Motu itself. Let's see how the food will be. We are taking our dinner, kind of. It will be relatively light, I would say, because, you know, for the obvious reasons, we don't want to crash into the mountains and vomiting, you know, ourselves there. So yeah, that's where we are.
Thank you. Alright, so as he's already given you an update, I won't be saying the same thing, but there's something that I would like to point out, and that's the fact that the only issue that I have when I'm traveling is the fact that there are no clean washrooms. So I am a little happy that we stopped over here. We'll only be able to update you once we reach our hotel, which is like 20 minutes drive from the bus stop where the bus is going to drop us. That is a little about that, and I'll see you around. Bye bye. Some not so light dinner. A quick update, as you can see my shoulder is still red and it's hurting me because I was carrying the bag, but I am a little scared honestly for tomorrow, because tomorrow I gotta carry it all the way up to the Trihund trek. However, I'm not quite sure how I'm gonna do it, how I am going to pull it off, but we'll see. So I'm just hoping for the best, and yeah, that's about it. Yep. So, I'm just trying to give you a quick update. Sorry. He's okay. A little taller than me.
I can certainly.
I'm sorry for that.
No.
Sorry.
Yep.
Okay, so the food was below average?
No, I would say not even average. It was not even below average. It was
worse.
Rubbish.
Yep, we did not even finish it.
No.
We did not even eat it halfway. We left it.
Yeah.
I just had two bites and I did not even feel like taking the third one. We are not the kind of people who waste food, but it was just too bland. It had no flavors in it. It wasn't cooked well. Yeah, that's how it was. And plus the service was not that great, to say the least.
It's okay, but yeah.
The waiter was kind of clever though.
Yeah, so he charged the extra tip. I gave him a certain amount and he automatically increased the amount and then deducted that from my card. And like when I saw the slip, I said, okay.
Yep.
So yeah, kind of.
We being the kind people, we did not complain about it, but we felt bad. We felt cheated. So yeah, that's the update as of now. We will be updating you tomorrow now. Bye bye for now. Good night. And now we are walking up all these stairs that I just showed you.
There are 189 stairs.
Yeah.
So they're gonna lead us to the market.
From where
we will take a taxi or an auto towards the checkpoint. Yeah, let's see how it goes.
Yeah. I'm quite excited already. Way to Trihun. So as we just told you, there are signs which say way to Trihun, and there are also signs saying the trek starts. So we are excited for the same.
Yep.
See how it goes.
Just quick pro tips: before you go to any other trek, make sure you have ample amount of water. We got like a lot of bottles with us.
We've got like in the back. 4 or 5 liter water. Yeah, this Gatorade, an energy drink.
Plus, salts, it will control. Then we also have ORS to keep our salts and everything intact.
Yeah.
Intact. So yeah, just need to make sure because the sun can really kick you down with the energy. So yeah.
So we have started the trek,
yep.
And we are almost like 2 kilometers or 1.5 kilometers up.
1.2.
Yeah. So I'm running a little out of breath, to be honest. But and plus it's way too sunny than we had expected initially, which is good and bad both. Good because we don't have to wear a lot of jackets, but bad because we did carry a lot of stuff with us. Like we did carry raincoats, we also carried our jackets and extra stuff that we thought we might need. So yeah, that's that, and I'll keep you updated. Bye bye. There are some stones that are like so steep, it's almost like we are walking at 45 to 50 degree angle, which is crazy, but we're enjoying it. We are almost halfway there, and
it is exactly halfway,
but it's way too sunny.
And we took like 72 minutes, so according to this, we will take another 72 minutes, which means 2.5 hours, which is pretty decent if we could do that, because people downstairs were telling that the locals here can do this in like 2 or 2.5 hours,
uh-huh.
And it will take us 5 hours, so. I don't know how the trail will be from here, how steep it would be, but I hope we could make it. But no rush, honestly.
Yeah, we're enjoying it.
Hydrate yourself, get something in the glucose, the things that you have thought will not be good for you. Example, those chocolates, those cakes will be good here because you would be needing a lot of energy during this.
Yep. And we added some ORS into our water so that we can just keep on sipping it.
Yeah, that's to balance the salts and make sure
we also got some electrolytes along.
Alright.
That's about it. Alright, we are back here again. So now let's talk about the actual trek. There are two ways to start your trek. One is through Dharamkot and the other one is through
Baksunath.
So we took the Dharamkot one because
Baksunath is very steep and it's not for the first time trekkers like us.
Yeah. And it's way more difficult.
Yep. And if you're a first time hiker, I would say you will kind of find this one as well difficult, considering the fact that it's not easy when it comes to the sun that is beating down, and you need to have good shoes. Like, I'm not asking for trekking shoes, good sports shoes will also work. Good clothes, your trousers, you should have joggers or something like a cargo, more pockets, you know, and keep your luggage light, as light as you could, or as you can, because again, They are something that are necessary. Yeah. We kept a raincoat just in case, because the weather forecast said it might rain.
It might rain.
So we wanted to make sure that we are covered from that.
And then we have a lot of water with us.
Oh yes.
And water, some food articles to eat along the way. And plus, because we are into gymming, so obviously we've carried a lot of protein with us, and oats and peanut butter.
Yep. You can carry so high fats, and you would like a peanut butter would be amazing. Mm-hmm. Because it keeps your energy for a longer duration. And I would also suggest some chocolates, despite of that's not really friendly towards your diet, but again, during these kind of hikes, you need extra energy. Your body burns a lot of glucose.
Yes.
And for that, chocolates or something which shoots
would
up
be your best friend.
Glycogen. Mm-hmm. Would be amazing. Some Gatorade, some ORS. Keep them handy. Like,
keep a lot of ORS with you. A
lot of water, and as many as ORS pouches, sachets, whatever you call them. You carry them as much as you can. They're pretty cheap, I guess 10 or 12 bucks.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty neat. And they're pretty good as well. They keep you hydrated. So while I'm walking, I know I'm very well hydrated.
Yeah. So we came here thinking, because people told us there's gonna be snowfall, but
there will be some snowfall.
Yeah, but look at the amount of snowfall that's here. Ironic, isn't it?
I don't know.
Do you have any comments about it?
This is not snow.
This is not snow for sure. This is like a box of ice cubes. But the view is nice though. I'll give them a peek of the view. Day one, and we finally reached our destination, which is Triund, after like 4.5 hours.
Yes, 4.5 hours in total.
Mm-hmm.
Because we took the route from
Dharamkot Chowk.
We did not go from Gallu Mandir.
Exactly.
Because from Gallu Mandir, this place is around 7 kilometers. Not around, but 7 kilometers and 250 meters.
Meters away.
Yeah, because I was keeping the track of the same on my watch. Yeah, we
took the longer route, and yet to be reached like way before the time we thought
exactly.
We would.
I mean, people so, down there from Gallu Mandir were telling us that
yeah,
it will take out 5.5 hours to complete this hours, but
our whole journey was 4.5, so that's
fine. Yeah, and we took what 3.40, I guess.
Yeah,
to reach here. So yeah, but
kind of
having
proud
said
of
that,
ourselves.
Yeah, we did not take a lot of break. I'm proud of her because, well, she is asthmatic, so that has you know
its own
complications, and you know oxygen levels and all are quite low, because we are right now at what 28.13
elevation
from
level.
from the
sea level.
It's quite high. Just to give you the context, when I was sitting at my home, I was at 213, and it is just 2600 more than that. And if I compare that from the place we are staying at, Dharamshala, exactly McLeodganj, it is 1500 there. So we came around 1300 plus elevation, right? If you're a first time trekker, let me tell you this. This isn't easy. In the sense, you will be tired.
And no matter how much people tell you that you'll be tired, you still feel the enthusiasm or the hormones kick in, saying that, okay, you're saying that it's hard, but I still would be able to do it. But let me tell you, why is it hard? It's hard because, number one, it doesn't have any clear roads. So whenever you'll be walking, you'll be constantly walking at 45, 50 degree elevation and on rocks that are trembling sometimes.
And are pokey as well.
And some are slippery. So there's no defined pathway. It's all just made up of rock pieces put together at high altitude. So it becomes even more challenging. Like even a small patch becomes challenging because you're constantly, it's almost like you're climbing three stairs at a time. It's like one stone would be here, the other would be here.
Yeah.
It's almost like jumping three stairs up. So that's how it is. And that is why it is tough.
But yeah, the view is pretty much worth it if you could see here.
Love it.
I mean, this is the place over here. That's the Dharamshala in McLeodganj.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure how well you guys can see this, but that's the place.
Yeah.
There. It's cold here. You could see we got our jackets up. And sometime the guy will set up a camp for us.
Yeah.
It was raining though. Mm-hmm. Yes, we have to mention that. We did the smart thing. We did check the weather and it said there are chances of rain. So what we did, we carried the raincoats. So, I mean...
And also we had a waterproof bag.
Oh yeah. So make sure you have a waterproof bag or at least a cover for a bag.
Well prepared.
Exactly. Or cover for your bag. I mean, either ways, it's just fine.
Yeah.
Because some bags are waterproof, some are, you know, have the covers inside the bag. So basically, the point is that be well prepared.
Be well prepared.
Check the things before you come. Mm-hmm. And check the weather. Do your bookings in advance.
And also, the people try to trick you. Like, for example, some would say that don't get your speakers, wherein we deposited our speaker at the starting point.
Yeah, at the point Gallu Mandir where the police checkpost was. Yeah,
but then en route to this place, we saw like a lot of people carrying their speakers.
I mean, while we were coming up, people were like, playing and we were like music.
Feeling like a fool because we were honest and we submitted it. Likewise, it's for the tent system. They would say that you need to book a tent before you go up. And that is also an additional trick because you can book it when you come up as well.
I mean, we did not check it yet.
We weren't aware because we were the first time travelers. I mean, and we trusted the locals. We thought the locals are guiding us.
So basically, you see the tent right there in the blue. So that blue tent, this one. There is a sticker over here. It says you can get your tent or rent your tent from here.
Yeah.
And but we did not check it. We will check and let you know if they book it from here as well. I'm sure they do.
It was written on the shop from where we just kept our stuff. So we are quite sure that you can book it from here as well. But we weren't aware of this. We trusted the locals and we decided to do it from downstairs, which I think is way more costlier than booking it upstairs.
So
but
they can ask you somewhere around 1100, 1200, 1400 bucks. So, you know, as far as the rent goes, the rent could range somewhere from, like, for per person, they could ask for 600, 700, 800 for the tent. The guy asked us 600 bucks per person,
mm-hmm.
and we somehow made him agree. We were asking for 400, but he agreed on 500 per head. We gave him 1,000 bucks, and he will set up the camp over here. They say there's a 5-minute walk from this location in the, you know, same grassy area.
Yeah.
So let's see how it will be. We'll show you that as well. And honestly, the place is pretty beautiful. Some things that I would suggest you is
keep a check on the weather.
Keep a check on the weather. Bring food.
Plan it on weekdays.
Plan it on weekdays because it will be relatively cheap if you can do that.
And bring a lot of water and food because the higher you go up, the costlier it is going to be. So basically a 20 rupees water bottle is going to cost you 40 at like 3 kilometers or middle of the trek. But at the higher altitude, it
might go to 80.
Yeah.
So that's what you need to do. Also, bring your food. If you can, from downstairs, you can pack it, bring it up, you can have it. Or you can also opt for you know, I don't know how the food will be, just to be, you know, on the safer side. If you know something, some people cook good food downstairs, grab something, come up and have your, if you're planning for an overnight stay. So that's what we are doing for now, the overnight stay. And yeah, that's it. Rest we'll tell you. And yes, one more thing I should mention, there is no power supply over here, nothing at all. Somehow our cable and power bank fucked
up. Messed up.
Yeah,
really bad.
We really now in a situation that we don't have the battery, and we asked for this guy, but they said we are using solar panels and there is no sun out there right now. If the sun will be out, well, we might be able to charge our phones, or else boom, nothing, no networks. Networks are not here even. So yeah, be sure that everything works and nothing just breaks down at the very end, because that's the same thing happened with us. So yeah, that's about it.
Thank you. Hey, just a quick update that we weren't able to film on our way down, and that's because of two things. One is the fact that there's no electricity up there at Triund, so we weren't able to charge our phones. And secondly, because we did carry power bank, however, our power bank decided to ditch us, and the socket that we wanted to use to charge it wasn't working. So even though we had a fully charged power bank, it was still useless, and thus we weren't able to film on our way down from the trek. So that is about that. And yeah, after this I am going to post a few pictures as well as a few reviews of certain places, like places where we had good experiences and places where we had bad experiences, like Tibet Kitchen, wherein the food was terrible, the quantity was terrible, there was no chicken found, and yet it is expensive. So I want to save your money so that you don't land up spending your hard-earned money over there and not enjoying the meal that you intend to. So yeah, that's about that. And I would sign off with this, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
But we couldn't get the cake, so here is a little cake that we are working with, a brownie, dark chocolate that she likes.
Happy birthday.
Let me make your feet first. Right? Happy birthday.
And now one for you.
I'm good. Good.
But it's sort of like the same as what I bake at home.
Yeah. But even better, the one that you bake. Honestly, I'm just not trying to overdo the things, but just because the view is good here and the songs are also good. So, yeah, that's that.
Thank you.